this video now is on life cycle costs. How do you calculate life cycle costs? Well, this is one of the easiest costing methods that you will come across in your management accounting. It's not so difficult to approach. So this question is saying, Kanyambi company specializes in the manufacture of small range of high-tech products for the fitness market. They are currently considering the development of a new type of fitness monitor, which would be the first of its kind in the market. It would take 1 year to develop, with sales then commencing at the beginning of the second year. The product is expected to have a life cycle of 2 years before it is replaced with a technologically superior product. The following estimates have been made. So basically, what are we looking at in life cycle costing? Well, we are looking at all these costs that will be involved, you know, in bringing up your products, starting from the stage of maybe research, okay, research costs, design costs, all those things, you know, that are just involved in maybe bringing up something that is new. That's basically what life cycle costing looks at. Yeah, so as you can see on the screen, you have the research, development, product designs, marketing costs. So all these, we will need them as we are calculating the overall life cycle cost of this product they're trying to make. So you've been putting, you know, fixed costs, other things, you know, fixed costs could be so many examples, rental, whatnot. Yeah, distribution costs, variable costs, and the like, as you can see. Not you should ignore the time value of money. Okay, so just an additional point. Required, what are we being asked for here? Calculate the life cycle cost per unit. So before you even find the cost per unit, you need to know the overall cost first. Then you can come and just divide into per unit to be much easier that way. So what are we going to do? Well, you've got 3 years stated on the equation. This is basically the time period that your particular product will last. So what you're going to do is that all the years and their particular costs, you start adding them year by year, to not even make a mistake. Just go year by year. Yes, so you start with year one. You're going to start adding the 160, the 800,000, the 1,200,000, and the 200,000. You add them. That's your first component that you add. You even put it aside. You go to year two. Year two, okay, it has started with some units that were manufactured in that year. Okay, that's like 100,000. We'll need that detail very soon. Then you also look at the 1 million. You take into consideration. You start adding 1 million plus what? There's a 40 kwacha, but is that an overall cost? No, it's a kwacha per unit. So what do? You have to, we're looking for the total cost first as at now. So multiply that 40 by the 100,000 units, you get like 4 million somewhere there. Okay, yeah, so that's basically what we're doing. Then you got the next component after 40 kwacha per unit, which we have just now multiplied, giving you that 4 million. You got the next one, 650,000. Yes, you pick it as well. Then there's the next one, distribution costs, which are variable costs per unit, 4 kwacha. So this is a per unit cost. Equally, we'll do the same. This is year 2, so you have to multiply the units which are in year 2, which is 100,000 units. When you multiply that one, it gives you 400,000. The next one is 120. Also take it, that one is an overall cost. Then there's another one, 3 kwacha per unit. That one, which is a fixed selling. So again, do the same thing. Senior 2, 3 kwacha per unit, multiplied by certain units there, which is 100 units, it gives you 300,000. You have the next one, 180 and 900. The summation of year 2 should be about 7,550. That's 7,550,000 kwacha. We go to year 3. Year 3, we have 1,750,000. Okay. Oh, so that 200, sorry. That 200 is just units. First, we do not add it as at now. So start with on this 1,750,000 when adding. Go to the next one, 42 kwacha per unit. That one is in per units multiplied by a certain number of units, so you can get the total cost of what is it referring to? That's the manufacturing variable costs. So 42 times 200, since it's in year 3. That's why we're multiplying by the units in year 3. Yeah, then you find 8,400,000. You go the next one, 1,290,000. The next one, which is under distribution cost, 4 kwacha 15 gwe. Equally, this is a per unit cost. Do the same thing where in year 3. The units in year 3, 200 kwacha. you multiply, it gives you, this one will give you how much? 4 kwacha 15 way, okay, by 200, kwacha is 900. The next one is 120, okay, then there's a 3 kwacha 20 ngwe there. It's also a per unit cost equally multiplied by the units in year 3, which is going to give you 640,000. You have your 180 and you have your 1,500,000. Sum up year 3, you should land up to a cumulative total of 14,780,000. Let me just show you the next screen on how we will now put all the 3 years together. So first, have a look at the screen there. You have the 3 years listed. What I was just saying is that you should go year by year, getting the total costs. Huh? So what I've done here on the screen is that I've summed up all the costs as of each year. Even those on which were per unit, I've already done the month and I've multiplied them by their respective units in their years. And those are the figures I came about within each year. And those are the cumulative totals as of each year. It's much easier if you take this approach, you won't make a mistake. Then you just sum up those totals in each year. That's what I did. I mean, I got 24,690,000. That's what I got. Yeah, so once you get that total, that's your cumulative total cost of all the 3 years, then you divide by the number of units, because they said it's a cost per unit. And you know, before you even change something to per unit, you need to know the total units that were equally available in all the 3 years. It was just 300 units. When you just divide the 300 units, as you can see, you tell me that you get the life cycle cost per unit of 82 kwacha 3 ngwe, or 13 ngwe if you want. Yeah, so basically that's life cycle costing. Nothing, should I say, complicated about it. It's one of the easiest approaches you should know as any student of management. Accounting should be one of the free marks, should be able to just score in your exams.